am an adult. I make adult decisions.
I am an adult. I buy my own goofies. I am an adult. I am an adult. I am an adult.
Are you?
We did not plan that.
All right. Apparently, adults have this, some adults, not all adults, okay? They're good people on both sides. So look, there is this growing obsession with something known as Squishmallows among an adult clientele. Now, Squishmallows, I know about because one of my nieces is obsessed with them and I purchased Squishmallows for her last Christmas. But now people in their 20s are collecting them, and this is part of what is referred to as the kidulting trend or phenomenon. So let's talk about what this is. So according to Jazwares, which acquired Squishmallow parent company Kelly Toy in 2019, fans 18 and up are driving sales. A private company, Jazwares, does not release sales figures, but Circana, love these names, reported the 16-inch Squishmallow was the top-selling toy of 2022 in the United States and Canada. Now, what exactly is a Squishmallow? In the video that we showed you, you may have noticed these cute little stuffed animal things. Those are the Squishmallows. And I will say that as someone who has been in the presence of Squishmallows, they are in fact soft and squishy, so that's fun. They also have names and various characteristics assigned to them. We'll get to that in just a moment. But apparently the toy has over 11 billion with a, wow, 11 billion impressions on TikTok?
Yeah,
there's insane.
There are now tons of Squishmallow creators and influencers. Like the toy has influencers that are dedicated to just making videos about them. One of the guys has 9.6 million subscribers. And overall, I always want to call them marshmallows. The Squishmallows, and I'm going to call them mallows. I don't like the mallows. The Squishmallows have 11 billion impressions, which is a ton of impressions.
You're just going to rename it?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. All right. Okay. All right. I guess you could do that.
Why not? I'm taking Shakespearean liberties with it. Okay. And I have personal experience with these Squishmallow fellas, which I'm going to get to in a second.
So here's the question. Are we doomed in America? Is the future of America in trouble? Look, this isn't the first time this has happened, right? So I remember when I was growing up, Beanie Babies were a collector's item.
Mm-hmm.
And so, no, we're doomed. We're doomed. Things things got worse after that. So it's over.
No. I'm gonna go in the exact opposite direction, okay?
Interesting.
So first of all, the experience I have is that my daughter loves them. We got a picture.
Your daughter is like 5 years old.
No, she's 10 to be accurate.
Oh, sorry about
but
that.
Hold on, it's gonna go more. So we got the picture. This is a terrible picture I took as soon as I saw we were doing this story of her bed. I mean, it's like the worst picture ever. But it gives you a sense of like the thousands of, that's not all of them. She has more than that. So she loves them. And then my son who's 12, he borrowed one of them. And I was like, oh. That's interesting, right? Like, so these things are like really popular in a way I didn't expect. And then my wife bought some.
He borrowed a Squishmallow.
Yeah, because he liked it so much.
Oh, okay.
Okay. And then my wife liked him so much, she bought a couple.
Is there like a Squishmallow rental place? Like,
no, he borrowed it from Joy.
Oh, got it. Okay.
And so I realized this thing's on fire. Right?
Like, on fire.
Whenever a toy's on fire, I know because of my daughter. Like, remember the Poppets?
I do.
Like, that was on fire for a little while. She's like, Poppets, right?
She's a child, though.
Yeah, child. Yeah. But notice my wife also liked them, okay? So now okay.
Gotta be careful, boss's wife likes the Squishmallows, got it.
So, and they're lovable little fellas. I'm gonna get back to that in a second, why they're so popular. But for adults in specific, the reason I'm disagreeing with you, Anna, is because I think that during COVID that's when they really took off. And during this time of like crazy politics and bad news and so much vitriol online, this became like a little oasis for people. And they felt like a bit of a connection to them because they all have stories. They're like, oh, this one is shy. This one is looking for a friend. This one's a professor, whatever it is. They have these little backstories. And people go, aww.
Okay.
And it's like a watered down dog. It is the same reason you get a dog, but it only costs $3.99 or $9.99. And you go, okay, that one I can take care of. And it's squishy and it's fun and it's cute. And you relate to it. It's innocence. And that's why it's taking off with adults, because adults are desperate for some degree of innocence in this ugly world.
Okay, let's go to graphic 5, because I want to give examples of their personality strength. I'm gonna explode. Okay, so each Squishmallow has a name, a squish date for when they were born, and a detailed backstory. There's Winston, an aspiring chef owl. Leonard, a vegetarian lion who loves to nap. Tatiana, a dragon who has dance-offs with friends and goes to the library. And Lalinda, a polka dot giraffe pop star.
They all sound lovely.
Yeah. You know that story that you tell time to time about Pro when he was little and you wanted to like build up his immunity, so you rolled him around in the dirt?
Yeah.
Right? I feel like we need to do that with everyone in the country,
yes,
with all the adults.
Yes.
Okay? Like, I'm actually a little bit concerned with how much people are infantilized these days.
Mm-hmm.
You get what I'm saying?
No, I do. But I think you can do both. I think you could have a grown-up life,
yeah,
and then come home and have a little squish feller, right?
Look, I have no problem with adults having Squishmallows, right? But what I am concerned about is the second half of what you say we can do with both isn't happening. Like,
yeah,
there's,
it's escapism, and you're worried that they're escaping reality too much.
I just, oh God, everyone's gonna hate me so much for saying it, but I have to say it. Everyone is just overly sensitive and overly soft, and we have real freaking issues in the country that need to be solved. You
I
get
know,
what
but
I'm
those
saying?
Particular,
and you're not gonna solve it with like a 2,000 Squishmallow collection.
I hear you.
And I know, I'm being too harsh. I just gotta,
So what you're actually saying is, it's not for you, it's for other people, okay? And so, look, we gotta tackle the bad news. We're in that business, and we gotta go fight for you guys, and we gotta go bring you change, and we gotta be grown-ups, right? But not all of you have to do that, right? Like, that's not your job. And if you wanna hide in a little cave filled with Squishfellers, I get it, brothers and sisters, I get it. You know, go on, look, if it's harmful to you in that you're not engaging with other human beings and you're not going on dates and you're not interacting with your community, then it's a bad thing, right? But hey, you're the queen of the furries, right? And as not a furry,
am I the queen of the furries? Like, we need to stop saying that, because the furry community is gonna be like, we don't even know you, bro. Like, what? Anyway, sorry. But I do support them, you know, they should have freedom
to
be
them. So, like, over a decade ago, Anna did a video supporting the furry community. The furry community exploded with feathers flying everywhere in excitement. And that's when she became the queen of the furries. So you know, hey, you do you, boo, that's your thing, right?
No, it is. Look, I'm not calling for a ban on this. And I'm not like, let me just be clear. I'm not mad or disturbed by anyone who's into this at all. I'm making a broader point, not only having to do with Squishmallows. It's what the Squishmallows and the adult affinity for them represents to me, which is, yeah, a little, like, I am a little bit worried that there's too much. It's God, I can't do it.
I know
I'm
what you want to say.
I'm gonna
Can
get
I
into
try?
Too much trouble because it's too harsh. But the reality is, like, there's a problem with the lack of adults right now, everywhere.
Mm-hmm.
There's a lack of, like, everywhere you go, there's this issue. Like, where are the adults? When can we get the adults in the room? Like, in every situation. So, like, when I see a story like this, it triggers me because it makes me think about specific issues that we're experiencing in finding the adults.
Yeah, okay, I see where you're coming
from.
Like, in the sense that, like, for example, especially the last couple of weeks, although the last 6, 7, 8 years, we've been talking, like, the the country's turned into a circus.
Yeah.
Right? Mm-hmm. And like now Mark Zuckerberg and Elon Musk are gonna wrestle or something, right? And like everything's a circus. Elon Musk was the richest man in the world. And you'd think like a serious, sober-minded guy, and it turns out he's a buffoon. Like right. Everyone's a clown. I think that's the frustration you're having, like, that there's no adults.
Like I think about some of the great minds in America's past that innovated and created these amazing things, and like, where are those people now? I'm like worried about the future of the country and the world. Like I'm being, and I know I'm taking this like fun story and I'm making it way too serious. Apologies for anyone I offended. I am not judging you for liking Squishmallows. I'm just making a comment, broadly speaking, about a problem I'm noticing in the country.
Yeah, I hear you, but remember the adults also destroyed this country, right? So the Bob Doles and the
adults who destroy the country are still there, but the counter to that, I feel like, doesn't even exist anymore. Do you get what I'm saying?
I do, but also there's a romanticizing of the past. So for example,
oh, I'm getting so many messages right now. People are not happy with me.
Okay. All right, hold on.
You know what? Squishmallows are awesome. In fact, I am going to engage in the collection, you know, culture very soon, maybe.
Okay.
But probably not.
Look, here's what I mean by romanticizing the past. Like, you know who figured things out? Albert frickin' Einstein, right? So there's a guy from the past. Man, he was a grown up and he figured things out. Also a giant goofball. Okay, so even though he was the smartest man on earth, he was incredibly goofy, right? So you can have both. You can have both. All right, now finally back to the and Anna, I think part of also what you're saying is touch grass, right?
Like that's not what I'm thinking about. Look. There is a lack of maturity among young adults right now. You can't have a conversation with them because they have been conditioned to think that everything is about their personal feelings. Everything is super narcissistic and self-interested. It's hard to find people to even hire. Let's keep it real, right? Like they don't take constructive feedback well. They like melt at every little like challenging moment in their lives. Like there is a problem with that. And so when I see a story like this, it just reminds me of that issue.
But as always,
everyone's looking for a nice little cuddly blanket to feel secure in, when in reality, like, I don't know. It's mixed,
guys.
Yeah, I know.
Because there's tons of great people you can hire, but is Anna right that you do run into these days disproportionately people who are all about themselves and need to be coddled, etc.? Yeah, you do run into that, right? But more so than you did in the past. That's also true. But there's also killers, and this place is filled with killers, right? So including everybody in this room. So it's all mixed, and I don't see Squishmallows in this camp. I see it in the camp of a respite, a little place where you go and you relax, and this is a thing that soothes you like Charlie does for you. And certainly you wouldn't begrudge anyone having a Charlie, right?
How dare you compare my dog to a Squishmallow?
No, I just made it worse. Made it worse, okay.
But like back in the day when adults needed like a little bit of comfort or a little like something to help them get through tough times, like, I don't know, they would engage in adult stuff like hanging out with friends or, you know, going to a spa, getting together with a girlfriend and getting your hair or nails done. Like, you know what I'm
Rosé
saying?
Rosé all day.
Rosé all day. Like, no, not even that, but like just adult activities. And I'm not, anyway. Let's
okay,
just move on. I've already dug. I've dug my own grave. I'm in the grave already. I'm done. Buried alive. It's over. Okay. You guys can all hate me. I deserve it. Apologies all around. But honestly, it is what it is. It's how I feel.
Okay. I love that the internet is so toxic that if you have like the most benign take, like, hey, I don't like Squishmallows.
No. It's not even that I don't like Squishmallows.
Like
I just
you're
think
dead. You're digging your own grave.
They're for kids.
they're for kids. They're not for grownups. You're digging your grave. That's it. You're over. You're canceled. You're dead.
By the way, you can like something that's specifically made for kids without going overboard, right? Like I go to Disneyland time to time. Right, but I don't have my entire home like decked out in Disney paraphernalia.
But some do. You do you, boo.
Yeah, I know. I know. Just do you.
Just
do
engage
you.
In the world as well. Do
sure.
both.
Sure.
Thanks for watching The Young Turks. Really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.